This is so satisfying. I don't know why, but I always keep on doing this. Automatic. So cool. Oh yeah, I have to drink water. I'm sorry. Bloober Games did really good job in making a lot of horror games. First of all, they made Layers of Fear, which was really good. And then they made a sequel of that game, which was not very much interesting to me because whatever was happening in the game didn't really bring any interest. And then there was this game of Blair Witch. A lot of people do not like Blair Witch because of how the game plays. But in my opinion, Blair Witch was one of the best games because it has the best atmosphere. Again, in my opinion, in a video game, which is in the horror genre, it has the best atmosphere all around. I was really scared because I was playing at 1 a.m. at night and it was scary. I'm just gonna say that. It was a really good experience. And now comes another game called The Medium, which is from the Bloober team. And it looks quite different than the other games that they have made. Now, The Medium, first of all, came in the Xbox Inside Xbox livestream, which was really good. I was really looking forward to how the game will be, because apparently at the end of it, it was shown that it is a dual reality kind of thing. At first, I thought that you will play one portion of the game in one reality and the other portion of the game in another reality. But that was not the case since we saw the new trailer for The Medium. And it looks completely different because you can simultaneously play both the realities at the same time. That is something that I have never seen, but I have seen snippets of it in different games as well. I quite don't remember what the game is, but I have seen snippets of it. Now, apparently the protagonist has some kind of power that she can go to a different world, a different reality where monsters exist. And in that reality, it feels like it's a post-apocalyptic world where monsters kind of rule. And you have all of these places and you have these powers with you that you can use in your post-apocalyptic other reality and use it to your advantage and find the secrets about your husband, I believe. The story is not so clear, but I believe that the gameplay mechanics is going to be a lot different. Again, you're not fighting a monster, which is completely fine in my opinion, but you are trying to get away from it and get rid of it. The dual reality kind of segment looks really, really nice. I don't know how I'm going to feel when I'm going to play the game because you're essentially seeing two different screens and you have to play at the same time. The character in both of those worlds are walking in the same place, in the same exact location, but with a different setting. One is like the present, the other one is a post-apocalyptic world. It's just the same, but things are different in both of these worlds. Maybe there's a door in your reality that is not open, but in other reality, you can actually open that door, or actually there is a passage that you can just walk into. And with the help of that, you can actually allow the present reality, your reality, to open the doors or help solve puzzles and maybe get rid of monsters or get more clues. Now, another thing is you don't play in this same location over and over again. Apparently, at some point of time, you do get away from one reality and you get stuck in your own reality. Apparently, she has powers, but she doesn't have control over those powers for a long period of time. You can only have that control for a short period of time, and then you can move forward. Once you're done with that power, you go back to your own reality and try to, you know, look for things and probably gain power back. One of the things that was shown in the gameplay showcase of The Medium was she has this power of electricity, I guess, where you can blast a surge of electricity all around in the other reality, and that can generate an electricity or a electric shock or wave in your reality, and it helps you solve different kind of puzzles. I don't know if that's going to be used to attack the monsters because you haven't seen anything like that, but it looks quite exciting. Now again, we don't have much more information on what is the exact backstory, how does she has this power. It looks a lot more like Silent Hill in a way. You have vibes of Silent Hill, maybe a little bit of Evil Within, and it looks absolutely gorgeous. It's not a jump scare game, at least. That's one thing that I like. It's not a jump scare game. It's scary and it's intense and you have a lot of things to take care of. You have to check around a lot of different things. It's again exploring, so you might get, like, there might be people who might get bored with it, because I know that a lot of people got bored in Blair Witch because there was a lot of exploring. You literally got to look around in every single direction. And I think that's one of the things that I like, because you get an idea that you have to explore every single area before you go forward or before you find a place to move ahead. And I think that is what it's going to be in this very game as well. You have to explore every single place, find out what to do next and how to solve this puzzle and where to go next, because I don't think so the game is going to give you hints on, oh, you go to the left, There's a passage over there, go through that, that's where you need to go. The game is not going to hint you that, so you need to find out where to go next, and that is going to be challenging. And then you have these monsters that apparently we haven't seen them yet. We haven't seen them in structure. We have only heard their voices, we have only seen your protagonist running away from those monsters essentially. I'm not sure if you will see them. I'm not even sure if they attack you. I'm pretty much sure that they do, but I don't know if you have a like chase sequence of them. I think you hide from them a lot and maybe encounter them one or two times, but maybe using your powers, you can like take them away for a small moment of time and then they will come back, something like that. Maybe the light that you have can scare them away. I don't know, but it looks really exciting. What do you guys think of the medium? I for one am very excited because I'm a horror fan and I really want to play some more horror games, and this looks absolutely fresh. Not fresh, but looks different and unique because you have dual realities, and after watching Dark, I really want to get into this reality kind of stuff. I definitely do not hope that there is time travel, but there is dual reality, which is really good, and I want to see how they're going to handle it. Thank you so much guys for watching this episode. Make sure to hit that like button if you enjoyed or like this kind of episode and want me to make more of these. I will definitely do so. Mention them in the comments below. What do you think about the medium? And do subscribe because we got more content coming up. Fan trailers, tributes, tutorials, and videos like these are coming straight away to this very channel. I also stream on Twitch, so do follow me on twitch.tv/givenmanners. Link should be in the description down below. I play a variety of games, but I usually play a lot of Call of Duty. I think I did like 3 to 4 takes on an outro. It's terrible in an outro. Well, at least we can do this. Oops. Drink the water before you end the game or end the video. You know what? You know what I'm trying to say?